Hi, and welcome to TMI Simulation Solutions Maritime Webinar Series, in which we will discuss with experts in the maritime industry the future of shipping. As we all know, the COVID-19 pandemic created new norms, presenting new growth opportunities, incorporating the fourth industrial revolution in sensing, in automation, robotics, and communication. In this webinar, we will take seafarers in a discovery journey into the future of the maritime industry, where technologies like augmented reality and artificial intelligence will be used daily in most of the processes on board of ships and on shore. For this, we will take a closer look into the important role digital innovation in workflows. Our colleagues from the STC Group's innovation team will talk about the implementation of remote technologies like remote education, coaching, and skills training. The outcome of using this type of innovation is to achieve a more resilient maritime ecosystem, easing the process of sharing knowledge across generations and ensuring lifelong learning. Both STC Group and TMI believes that learners should learn at their own pace, anytime and anywhere. That is why together we would like to share with the audience their commitment and their partnership to bring together STCSA innovation closer to African teachers and students. With this webinar, we seek to motivate the maritime businesses in the African continent and the rest of the world to change our mindset, embrace technology, and make the industry more attractive to youth. Before I have the pleasure of introducing our guest speakers in this webinar, please let me introduce myself. My name is Mariana. I am the marketing manager in TMI Simulation Solutions. My background is mainly education and the creation of a climate of culture of transformation through innovation. My role in TMI is to bring you and the team in TMI together to support you to innovate through the reinvention of the latest technologies and enhancement of training platforms. I am a firm believer in the power of digital innovation, but most of all, I believe in the power of people to make innovation work. So now please, let me introduce our first speaker, Mr. Adrian Butnaru.
Hi, it's a pleasure to meet you here, and thank you for inviting us here at this webinar.
No, thank you. Adrian is an experienced project manager specialized in design and development of complex software systems. He developed for more than 15 years a software for ship simulators and worked as technology expert in different projects coordinated by the Ministry of Transportation of the Netherlands, related to maritime innovation and also to vessel traffic. At STC Group, Adrian is responsible of enabling an innovation engine for technological disruption for maritime and port education. He's also the founder of Smart Innovation Program, where innovative startups, schools, and corporates from Rotterdam maritime ecosystems are encouraged to build partnerships for the future. In his work, Adrian tries to motivate teachers to become innovators and students to become great experts of successful entrepreneurs. Adrian believes that this is the right moment. This is the right moment to shift the focus of digital innovation in maritime from technology to opportunity. And this can only be possible in the maritime industry academies and schools that are joining forces to inspire, to involve in development and implementation of innovative ideas in the maritime sector. So welcome, Adrian, and thank you for joining us today.
Thank you.
Now let me introduce our second speaker, Mr. Frank Waszink.
Yes, here I am. Yeah, on the microphone of Adrian.
Okay, perfect.
It's really lovely to be here and to give you guys a demonstration of using the HMT1 I'm wearing on my head. So thank you for having me.
No, Perfect, and welcome, and thank you, Frank. Frank is a passionate teacher of the STC Group for almost 9 years. So, as I was saying, Frank works in the shipping department and provides technical lessons. In his lessons, he uses different working methods depending on the needs of his students. Recently, he has been intensively involved in the development of a digital engine room where the participant works with dual fuel engines using VR glasses. He also developed educational games, interactive e-learning modules, simulator scenarios to bring theory and practice closer together. Frank is passionate about teaching and about technological development in education. So welcome, Frank, and thank you for accompanying us today. So before we begin, I would like to request our audience to share their questions on the chat, as well as to congratulate our guests for such an exceptional career path. Please make sure that you share your contact details through the chat for us to share with you more information of STC Group and TMI Simulation Solutions training and consulting services. Now to begin, I would like us to start by giving our audience an overview of what are the latest innovations in the maritime industry today. So I'm going to share my screen because we prepared a presentation. As we all know, shipping is the most international of the world's industry, but also one of the most dangerous. That is why safety at sea is vital and dependent on professionalism and competence of the seafarers. It is estimated by the International Maritime Organization that over 80% of accidents are due to human error. So this is perhaps why the maritime training institutions are shifting from knowledge-based to competency-based training by integrated innovative concepts to the marine education, constant professional updating, and recertification of programs. So this is why there are four top digital trends in the evolving maritime industry. The first one that we will talk about today with Adrian and with Frank are autonomous ships. This is like in companies like Rolls-Royce Marine and the Japanese shipping giant Nippon Yusen have shared the plans of sending remotes and autonomous ships to sea. These ships will remain crewed to begin with, but as the technology advances, we'll see that some of those ships may be crewless by early as 2030, meaning that autonomous will likely become a part of a day-to-day onboard operations. The second trend would be the virtual and augmented or assisted reality. This type of training program can be used for crew to develop new skills, but also for crew entertainment. To further enhance onboard crew safety, operator owners are beginning to investigate the developments of wearable technology to assist the crew in solving technical problems, but also to ensure the health and well-being of the crew on board. Next, we have cybersecurity. For an industry that carries around 90% of the world trade, the first step in preventing cyber attacks is to identify the threats and vulnerabilities, assessing the risk exposure attached to these matters, and developing both protectionary measures and contingency plans to neutralize these risks as much as possible. Now, the fourth one would be e-learning. E-learning and distance learning are online training methods that bring together substantial value both for the company as a whole, but also for the individual seafarer. An online training solution makes the processes easier, faster, and most cost-effective. As we saw in the previous webinar, maritime trainers use innovative e-learning solutions to allow seafarers to access remotely through cloud platforms. Today, many individuals from all over the world comfortably have learned by using simulation that seeks the development of the skills and the experience required in terminals and ships. If we are looking now at the list of the trends All these will also have a major contribution to achieve important goals in the industry, like, for example, sustainability, green ports, digitalization, and enhanced resilience. Both STC Group and TMI have good examples of innovative training technologies that our teams are working on as we speak. I wanted to ask now, Adrian, a question, and also to give you the floor. As an expert, what would be those main benefits of using innovation in the maritime training? And also, if you can go through this into more detail, as I think it's extremely important to explain this to our audience.
Yes, of course, I can do this. Let's go through these trends, digital trends, or I don't know, modern trends into the maritime industry one by one. So firstly, I think that building fully autonomous ships from scratch or building semi-autonomous systems to be used on existing vessels will increase the efficiency of the operations on board. This is for sure one of the main benefits. Machines will automate and control the processes while humans will take care of more complex tasks. So it will be a kind of shift. At STC, we are building a new hydrogen-powered training ship called Ab Initio, which will be also equipped with an autonomous shipping module in the future. Also, together with our partners, the innovative towing company Kotag International, we have developed a minor for our students, focusing also on situational awareness in case of autonomous and remotely controlled ships. So you can see this way, we try to help students already to get familiarized with this technology of the future. The second trend, AR and VR, we can say that it's used mostly to add visual experience to the training in most of the cases, which is the most important use case for these technologies. But they also ensure a safer environment and reduce costs and allow remote training anytime, anywhere, which is very important. Augmented reality powered maintenance solutions are also of a great value by reducing the error rates, increasing the efficiency of operations, and of course, ensuring safety overall. AR in the form of assisted reality is considered by many shipping companies as the best solution for the future of remote support. For example, in case of unexpected technical problems on board or for executing or auditing regular maintenance tasks, technical experts will have many benefits in using by using this technology. You will see this use case being explained actually during Frank's demonstration a little bit later. The third trend, cybersecurity. In terms of cybersecurity, digital innovations allows identifying risk and mitigate them. This kind of tools will be used to assess the safety and contingency plans in the different systems used by the maritime operators. We all know that safe operations are always efficient operations. The last trend, and very much connected to us, STC Academy, is about evolution, and maybe we better call it a revolution of e-learning in the coming years. This technology brings benefits of substantial value to the value to the whole maritime industry chain, since online training solution makes the learning process easier, faster, and most cost effective. In combination with other digital technologies like 300 degrees filming, for example, or digital reality or artificial intelligence, e-learning will evolve to the next level, making the process of learning more convenient and actually hyper-personalized. However, these benefits are coming with major challenges maritime organizations are struggling with. For example, one challenge will be, for sure, how to capture that knowledge existing on the ship and transfer it across generations. How to build working on board experience as the crew and the time spent at sea will shorten. how to keep the digital skills of seafarers up to date as the technological evolution speeds up exponentially. These are some of the questions we have to answer in the coming period of time so we can keep the maritime sector attractive, performant, and safe.
Thank you, Adrian. It was it's a great recap. And now I would like to ask if you can detail what is STC Group doing currently in terms of AR? Are you up for that?
Sure, I'm happy to share this with our audience. Currently, we are developing a method of learning and training using augmented reality, or more precisely, assisted reality. We were actually inspired by the paradigm shift with Industry 5.0, where the frontline worker is now in the center of things, and the technical management level can connect to him in a seamless manner. We are talking about a connected worker nowadays. In this project, we try to mirror the industry use case expert frontline worker to a next level teacher-student interaction concept for vocational schools and technical universities. Teachers will wear the AR devices, smart glasses or head-mounted tablets in our case, and they will do examination remotely for students by evaluating the quality of the instructions the students gave. Students will enhance their technological skills and hands-on experience by using the head-mounted tablets and executing practical tasks. They are remotely guided by the teacher or are following automated work instructions called digital workflows. You will see this in the demonstration of Frank. In this method, both teachers and students will have the roles of expert or frontline worker depending on the objective, examination or learning. So in simple words, we are developing a remote coaching and skills training method using augmented reality and head-mounted tablets. Until now, we implemented some educational pilots with our teachers and students from the maritime faculty. And we are working now on promoting this learning method to the other STC colleges like ports, logistics and transport, and process industry. Next year, we plan a pilot program in cooperation with our colleagues from STC South Africa. So slowly, we are spreading this to your continent, I would say. But this is not everything. We are always in contact with the developments in the industry. So at the moment, we plan to develop a few pilot programs with some of our partners from maritime port sector. Of course, we are always open for new partnerships with major shipping and industrial companies worldwide. So all interested parties are welcome to contact us. What we are also trying to do is to share our knowledge with other schools and training centers in Europe and worldwide. We really believe in knowledge and knowledge sharing. So together with six other European technical universities and vocational education and training organizations, we initiated a strategic partnership in innovation funded by Erasmus Plus program of European Union. The project is called RELAR, Remote Learning and Examination by Using AR, and it aims to create a crisis-proof, resilient maritime education ecosystem by enabling remote learning and examination using AR. In essence, RELAR addresses the key challenges of the maritime port education ecosystem caused by the structural changes due to the new digital technologies. In the same time, the project focuses on the adoption of AR tools to improve learning outcomes. At the end of the project, the consortium partners will deliver an architecture and best practices for the development of remote learning systems and educational apps. We will also deliver three skills training scenarios for three different use cases like maritime engineer, shipyard technician, and fleet logistics fleet assistant. In 2022, we will organize different international events to disseminate the results of our project. I would like to use this occasion to invite everyone from the audience today to participate to these events. We will communicate this in due time on the webpage of STC Group and STC International, STC South Africa, as well as in the RELAR group of on LinkedIn. Having in mind our good relation with you, Mar, and the TMISS, I will ask you also the favor to publish next year the dates of these RELAR events on the website of TMI. So please follow TMISS and stay connected with us.
Thank you. This is very exciting, and we would be very honored of taking part of this. So this is a warning for Frank so he can start connecting, because dear audience, we will begin with our demonstration. And even though if I've seen a few days ago a glimpse of what you guys are going to see, I'm going to say that it's really amazing what they're doing. And I don't want to keep the audience in suspense. So I wonder if Frank is ready. Are you ready, Frank?
Thank you, Adrian. Okay, sorry. Yeah, welcome. Welcome to Rotterdam, the STC Group. And I'm Frank, and I'm working for the Rotterdam Mainport Institute. I made a small demonstration of possibilities, a lot of possibilities we have with this head-mounted tablet, the RealWear HMT1, it's called. So I'm wearing it now, and as you can see in your screen, this is what I see in a cinema wing. So I'm looking at Teams, and now I'm looking into the screen of my HMT, and I see the RealWear logo and the three possibilities to choose in the menu. The head-mounted tablet, it's called a head-mounted tablet because that's it. It's Android-based tablet. I wear it on my head, so the engineer, as I am, I'm free, I have my hands free to operate. The glasses, we have a camera. Now I'm opening the camera due to the English language. Navigate home. A camera on the glasses, a microphone. So I operate, as you can see, I'm muted now. I operate the system by voice. Navigate home. A lot of batteries, so I can use it for one day as constantly connected to the internet, to the small screen, so not asking a lot of power. I talk to it, so everything what I see, I can pronounce. Like if I want to go to my programs, I go to my programs library, and if I change the position of my head to the left, I go to the app drawer, I look in the app drawer and see all the apps installed on my device. So if you see here, I can start the application Teams by just saying Teams. Microsoft integrated Microsoft Teams for this HMT1 and works really snappy and nice. Navigate home. For this demonstration, I build a workflow. So what we can do with the glasses is we can, on board, we can provide remote maintenance by a workflow. I will demonstrate later. And we can provide remote assistance. So as an engineer, if I have a big problem, I can remotely call some expert at shore. For this, for workflow and assistance, we bought a program from Brocasia. I will start now. My programs, select item 4. So now I'm in the main menu of Brocasia, and as you can see, it's all about the software. So everything is possible depending on the software they build. In the corner, I see in the left, I see that I can call someone. I will not pronounce it because then it's opening. I can go to my media, my cloud, and now I go to my workflow. So I build an exercise for my students, and in this case, I have a valve in front of me, and the chief officer suspects that the valve isn't closing correctly anymore. So he asked me as a second engineer to do an inspection and make an analyze of this valve. But before doing so, it needs to be, I need to work on it safely. So I have to isolate this valve from the pressurized lines. To do so, I can follow a workflow I open now. Use QR. I installed already a QR code and it will open all my workflows. Now I have only one workflow, but you can imagine you can build many different workflows for different scenarios, more harder educational level or less harder. CLAP inspects the copy. I open the workflow by saying start process. So it's in my language, but I already told you the problem. We suspect it's not properly working anymore. Next step, collect all my tools. I did my homework. So I have my wrench, that's the important one. And of course I need to work safely, so I wear my gloves. Next step. Is the system under pressure? Well, I don't know. How do I need to check that? How? Next step. Get the gauge and open the drain. I really don't understand. Okay, how? Next step. Okay, next slide will provide me with an instruction video. Okay, that would be nice. Next step. Select item 3. Oh. Again, the gauge. Okay, that's the valve they're talking about. Yeah, and the pressure is 0. Perfect. No pressure on the line. Next step. Operation valve. I can do that. I don't need any instruction of it. I keep it open. Done. Next step. Okay, take out the 4 bolts carefully. Okay, I don't need any instruction. I can do that. I'm an experienced engineer. So while doing this, I can tell you that every student works nowadays or last year, so with 30 students in one classroom, one engine room, and one teacher. So the teacher can't see all the steps, all the decisions they made. So resulting also in sometimes damaged systems or like this as well. Okay. You cannot avoid that, you always be some damage, but now the teacher logs every step the student made. So when the student is finished working on this workflow, it will automatically upload to the cloud, and afterwards the teacher can individually look at the decision the student made. And that's a personal touch, I think, and I really love to use as a teacher. So, removing the 4 bolts, I will carefully, maybe it's still pressurized, take out this shaft itself. Navigate back. No. Okay. I did this. Yes. Okay. Done. Next step. Yeah, I take it out. Okay, done. And I need to inspect. Oh yeah, I see a lot of damage. Okay, done. Next step. So make some pictures for the chief, then he can see it, and for the teacher as well. Take photo. So what we have here is the valve part, and as you can see, it's damaged. So take photo. That's one photo. And inside you have the valve seating. And as you can see, it's damaged as well. Take photo. That would be enough evidence. Navigate back. Next step. So By activating, I will not pronounce it, but by activating that logo, I start recording my voice and I have to make an analyze for the teacher, for the team. Select item 3. Okay, chief. Yeah, I already see the problem. What the problem is. The valve is on the edge, totally damaged. And as well as the valve seating, it's damaged in the same way. I think it's probably due to the maintenance job in forehand when they put back the valve. So my advice is, I put this one back. Use it for the time being, and if you can order a new valve because it's totally damaged, and then we can replace it later. Select item 3. Now I'm stopped with my voice, and then you see the audio is saved. I can make another audio. I can make another audio if I want. Next step. So now I'm finished. The student is finished with his steps, and the student has his own personal PIN code. If they put it in and sign, then it will upload it to the cloud. And the teacher can discuss afterward. Mar, that's all for my demonstration. So back to you.
Thanks, Franz. Now I was wondering if I can ask questions, and at the same time, if I can, you both can answer some of the questions. I can see some already in our chat from some of the attendees. Maybe we can start with those questions. So let's go with the first one. First question says, is this training tool integrated currently to your programs, on which courses and how?
Yeah, it is now on the minor of of my school. And in this case, we are looking in a deep way to the human factor of using this technology. That's a thing I work on right now. I already gave these lessons. So basically, I let them work with it, communicate with it, and especially experience the downside of communication, because it's not like the holy grail of a new way of communication. You need a new way of a new process to communicate. And we found out during these lessons that communication between each other live on board is more effective than now communicating with these classes. So by exam and investigation, we use as well the students to evolve by using these classes.
And I want to add something. We are also our commercial entities, like STC International and STC Training and Consultancy. They are offering already short courses for people for workers to get familiarized with working with this kind of technology on board of ships or in factories where they are working. So we are still in the beginning, many piloting phases, many pilots implementations, but we are always open and we can provide our knowledge to others.
What we did during Corona time, when the school was closed and the engine room, what you saw also in the picture was testing the steering gear, and its operation you can theoretically tell the students, but now we could experience it, and they can give me orders as a all-round engineer on board. Give me orders to make those steps. And I think that's really nice that you have the theoretical part and then the practical part in combined.
Yes, to make it more realistic. I understand. Now, I think, I don't recall if you mentioned what is the cost of this type of technology, but somebody asked in our chat.
Yeah, so this is for me. How we started, actually, how we choose it. We have also, we are very careful with our budgets. We did firstly an evaluation. We evaluated many type of devices, smartphones, tablets, other type smart glasses made by other producers, and also HoloLens made by Microsoft. And we choose HMT1. So HoloLens is the coolest. HoloLens is cool, and probably the future will be for the HoloLens, but not in this form, because it's too much intrusive, and people working with HoloLens covering their face and eyes are not very happy with that. So probably will take a time. So that's why we choose HMT1, because it's less intrusive and lets you see the environment around you, the real environment. And as price, as you asked, one device is around 2,000 euro, best price you can get on the market in Europe now. And for this one, for this one. If you want software, like the one we are using now, you pay around 1,500 euro for a teacher building workflows for an unlimited number of students. And he can lead, he can monitor and coach from his laptop using this license for smart glasses, so four students wearing smart glasses in the same time.
Okay. Another question. It says that if this type of training tool is integrated, how much time does it take to develop these courses, and how does that compare with the traditional way of course development?
Yeah, I understand. I think the person who asked this question is a teacher or something, because these questions I get a lot. Depends a little bit on the software, but Brocasia made this software like pretty easy. So you take one item, if I want to add text or I want to take a photo, then I build up my workflow in my workspace, and that's pretty easy. But if you have a lot of decisions, so then it will be more complex. So depending on what line you want to follow, if you want to make a lot of choices, okay, make this choice and that results in these and these steps, that makes it more complex and more harder to build. So yeah, depends on the learning that you want to build. But from out of the box, the software is easy to use.
Yeah, and I would say the workflow you build once and you use millions of times if you want. So very reusable. You don't have to be in person. The student is taking the glass and start doing hands-on learning, following the instructions in the workflow. You just have to monitor maybe or assist him sometime.
Perfect. Okay, another question is about the average time will the trainee spend using AR in this course and why? And maybe this is allowing to understand how is the training a combination or a blended type of training?
Yeah. For now, exercises, I'm building exercises not longer for 20 minutes because I want to start with the whole group and then like talking about the reason why we do this exercise and the theoretical part. Then do the exercise and afterwards talk to the student in person. And as you can see, the one student is quickly finished and the other one takes a lot of time, follows all the instructions. So it's their own learning path. And so in the end, I take every student finished on the same time and take them together, talk about the handling they choose, the choices they make. So exercise not longer than 20 minutes.
Okay, thank you. I wanted to ask something about the difference between the head-mounted tablet and the HoloLens, but I think Adrian mentioned something that the coolest was the HoloLens, but yeah. It's it's better to use a HMT, right?
Yeah, for the moment. Probably the future will be for HoloLens, but we as school, we are also researching all the types. We do not exclude any device, any technology. We want to embrace everything, test it, evaluate it with students. So,
and I did a demo yesterday. I used it yesterday, the HoloLens, and it's incredible because the information, you see it in an overlay in this world, and the HMT1, it's there, but it's not like if I tilt my head, it changes also my view. So this is like the first step of AR. But you see, the industry is moving to these glasses, and it takes more time to adopt the HoloLens. So for now, we're using it.
Perfect. Okay. Well, this is great. From a pedagogical approach, I would like to say that it's a perfect blended learning tool. And I think that this type of learning allows a combination of different types of learning styles to allow better retention on the learner, right? I think that it's like you said, and I think I saw in one of your presentations a quote from Shun Shuang saying that tell me and I forget, and teach me and I remember, involve me and I learn. But it's related to what we believe as well here in TMI. Okay, so thank you a lot. It was amazing. I don't know if you would like to say anything regarding any other topics on the demonstration, but I think that if we can go towards the key takeaways that you have, I would really like to ask each of you to mention what's your most important key takeaway from the session. Is that okay?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Perfect. So perfect. I think, put you both on screen.
Yeah. So I think from project management and innovation management perspective, I think that it is vital for maritime organizations to understand that now is the time to change the mindset and to adopt innovation and finally reinvent themselves as a future-proof business organization. So my advice would be to be open to change, to listen to innovators, to reserve budgets for innovation, to cooperate with universities, research institutes, and training centers. So to give a try and don't be afraid of the failure, but really try to implement pilots. And last but not least, prepare your workers with the new skills for the future, because at the end of the day, it is all about people, I think.
Very true. Frank?
Yeah, well, I was thinking about this question. I was talking with my best friend yesterday, and he told me, if you spend as a person 10,000 hours on a subject, you will be an expert. And like, it's not like 10,000 hours, but my advice, what I think about this project is, I'm working at it. Things go wrong a lot of times. I have bugs. I was angry about the system, everything. And also working with some people who are, don't say old, but don't want to work with new digital methods, as keep on going and
find the right people, find the right colleagues, make it ambassadors of the
and just innovation. Try it and work with it, and you get excited.
Thank you. Well, so to our audience, we would like to thank you for watching, and for Frank and for Adrian for sharing their experience and motivating our audience a lot. You're truly inspirational and a great role model for the maritime industry. So I would like to say that we need to stay in touch. And for our audience, please write to the contact details that we will be displaying right now, but we'll display at the end, so we can offer more information in terms of support in training and consultancy. On behalf of TMI Simulation Solutions team and also the people behind the cameras, our guest speakers, we would like to thank you for joining the webinar series. And we would like also to share with you that next week we have our next webinar is with Arab. We will be talking about port resilience and smart port ecosystems. So please also join us. And we'll share with you our guest speakers in our LinkedIn page and also in our website, tmisim.com. So please make sure you register if you want to hear about the program and also any webinar recordings. Okay, so until next time, thank you and bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.